This is the stroker for the pump. Yeah, there's a something called a swash plate in here. It's like a round plate with a bunch of pistons on it. And when it's just sitting in this normal plane, that's the single plane across the shaft, or normal to the shaft, it doesn't do anything. But when you start to tilt the plate, it starts to stroke. It kind of does this type of thing. It's like a wobble. And each one of those pistons starts to pump. And the more you stroke it, the more it pumps. And it's all about volume and pressure. And that's how a simple hydraulic pump like this operates. You're just stroking the pump, making the swash plate twist or cant over a little bit to actually get some displacement on the pistons. Right, it's actually hydraulically connected here to that windlass right now. See these? That shows you that the hookup is this way and this way. And then when you spin this thing the other way, then you're going that way and this way.
Okay.
So you're just reversing it. That way you have redundancy. If something happens to the starboard power pack or hydraulic system, you can always use the port power pack to bring up the starboard anchor. So once again, redundancy. See this little thing here? You have to line it up with that. Once it's lined up, in theory, you can get that down, but you have to actually kind of go back and forth a little bit to wiggle it in. When you pull this thing out, you take the custom wrench, and fit it on there somewhere, and you actually force these things down. It's a little spiral that forces it down. You can see the spiral here. We just rotate this inner device, and then once these pins fall in, everything's locked together. Right now, what you have is the motor's turning, the capstan's turning through the gearbox, and everything else around the gearbox is turning, but this isn't connected to the Wildcat, which is the chain piece. So these big dogs are what actually connects the hydraulic system to the Wildcat, the Wildcat being the piece that holds onto the chain. Here we go. Gentlemen.